Hello, and welcome to another XPlane vid. Today we're taking off from Hendrik Airfield in South Africa, and we're gonna fly west to where are we going? Fissen Tekral. It's an aerodrome. Okie dokie. And let's see, what are we flying in today? This is the Bonanza. So let's just jump right in and get on with it. It seems to be very, very windy. This is a very, very small airstrip. 80 knots. It's one hell of a crosswind. Just under the cloud level by the look of it, which is handy. It's very very windy today. Gee, it's rather hard to fly manually and do this at the same time. It's actually kind of fun. In a weird, twisted, perverted kind of way. Again, that's another one of those areas where there's this beautiful scenery. The aircraft is so nicely detailed as well. Zoom in a little bit on her. The bump mapping on there. The lights, nicely detailed. Even the cockpit. Nice, now his headphones on. See the clouds just starting to cover the top of the mountains. Or the hills, or whatever you want to call it. It's looking much better than before. Still need to find some good textures for the ground. As you can see, the ground is still very pixelated, I guess is the word. But I just wanted to really add in those MAXX add-ons that somebody was nice enough to do, and they're completely free. You go to xplane.org to the file section once you've registered, and you can download them completely free and throw them in. Now there's quite a few very good free add-ons. While I was there, I also grabbed another two. One's called Real Cities, another one's called Real Beaches. Beach as in the thing with sand and water, not the woman standing on the corner screaming. And I'll add those in and remove the MAXX ones and see if there's much of a difference. So yeah, I changed my mind. We're going to head for Robertson, which is roughly in this direction. I just have to follow the mountain line, which is looking pretty nice, and should get me there. Flying into some clouds about a little bit. Looked fantastic, but whatever. It happens. Again, this is another one of those nice little aircraft. This is a payware aircraft, it's not free. And by Canero, it's very well animated. It's got the trim flaps animated as well. They're slightly up there because I go going a little quick, so I've had to trim her down. Looks like I'm side-slipping a little bit too. It's still kind of windy up here. From up here, the ground doesn't look too terrible. It still looks pretty blurred and pixelated, but yeah, I'm not worrying too much about it. I actually have the World Edition of XPlane, which is why I can pick and choose where I want to fly anywhere on the globe. What I usually do is use Google Earth, find somewhere that looks interesting, and then zoom in and see if I can find some airports close by, and eyeball a route that way. Not particularly professional or anything like that, you know, I'm not following a flight plan. Probably go down a little bit. Okie dokie. So I dove out of the clouds. It's getting a little windy as well down here. I think I'm picking up a lot of turbulence from the hills around. And I'm actually flying real weather right now, or real world weather. As best interpreted by the system, which actually does a pretty good job. You know, it does a lot of calculations. Somewhere ahead of me, I believe that's it there. There's an airport. Which is awesome. The compliment's very swish. If you're going to get X-Plane, I really do recommend a good joystick with at least two hat switches and a throttle, because one hat switch, trying to move around the cockpit like that, left and right, down and up, and a tilt and zoom and whatnot, can become a little frustrating when you have one hat switch and you've got to keep taking your hand, smacking the keyboard around you. Cut the throttle a little bit here because I know we're getting close to where I'm going to be. As I mentioned, I did turn the graphics up a touch to this. I turned off the anti-aliasing and let the graphics kind of take over there. Because I have it on override in the drivers, so. That looks like my airport down there. A little bit, because I'm kind of high. Yeah, this is my first outing in this particular aircraft as well, so this is going to be an adventure for everybody, including me, especially with that nasty crosswind down there. This is a wonderful thing about flying in a flight sim, is you can cheat. You can use the external view and look at areas that you really wouldn't be able to see if you were actually flying. So I think I'm going to try and come on that runway there. So cut the throttle. you can see, and lots of nicely placed trees and things. I turned on right there, that guy. Look, it's a balloon. It's a hot air balloon floating in the sky for no apparent reason. And hot air balloons and forest fires are turned on in this, because you know it's a pretty nice set. Side-slipping a little bit there, I'm not... Well, this is going to be an interesting landing. I can't see the runway! Flying sideways. This is actually pretty awesome. I think I'm going to change my approach to that other runway. Maybe a little more sensible rather than trying to land sideways. I'll try and land on this runway that's facing into the wind. That's a heck of a wind out there. Well, we managed to land. Can't say it's very safe, but we managed to land. Thanks for watching.